Am I framed up right? Yeah, there we go. All right. Welcome, everybody. This is our segment where we have the latest news of Star Trek and the Orville. Still waiting on a renewal notice for the Orville. We don't have any news there, but we do have some Star Trek items. Scott Bakula making an appearance during the recent Trek Talks 2 fundraiser to benefit the Hollywood Food Coalition. During a panel, he talked about the troubles that Enterprise had when it was on the air, mainly because of outside circumstances. UPN and WB both were in the offing at that point. Enterprise was a flagship show for the UPN network. Dean Valentine left as president of the network. A number of people at Paramount left. And then UPN and WB merged to give us the CW. There were a lot of different things that were going on. And Bakula figures that if they had just been directly syndicated, like Next Generation had been, they would have gotten 7 seasons. Maybe. Bakula also addressed the question of whether he'd be willing to come back to play Jonathan Archer again. And he said, yeah, I've been doing this long enough that I don't say no right off the bat to anything. So he's open to it. He's also open to doing some animated voice work as Archer. So we will see what we will see on that. And announced this week, Star Trek continues to celebrate the 30th anniversary of Deep Space Nine. We've got the next entry in the Captain's Autobiographies, this one examining the life of the emissary, the Autobiography of Benjamin Sisko. Written by Derek Taylor Attico, it tells the story of Sisko's career in Starfleet and his life as a father in the Emissary of the Prophets. Although I'm not quite sure when Benjamin would have written this, given how Deep Space Nine ended. But no spoilers. Mrs. Boss hasn't gotten there yet, because we're going through Deep Space Nine now, and we're about to watch the last episode of the 6th season and into the 7th, so don't say anything yet. Now available for pre-order, release date and artwork yet to be determined, the Next Generation films in 4K Ultra HD, Generations, First Contact, Insurrection, and Nemesis will each be available separately, and the three will also be bundled in a collection. And that's it. That's all of the Star Trek and Orville news that we've got this week. So make sure that you tune in next week for more, and we will have all sorts of things that we pay attention to. And if you have any news items you want to send to us, we've got ways that you could do that too. Make sure that you are subscribed. Put a like on that video if you want. Feel free to share it. We'll be back with more next week.
Copyright 2023 by Flaming Dog Media, LLC. All rights reserved. No portion of this program may be retransmitted without the express written consent of Flaming Dog Media. You're watching Sci-Fi for Me TV, delivering the multiverse since 2009.